I work within the Advanced High Voltage Engineering Research Centre here at Cardiff University, and that's divided into two laboratories. We've got the High Voltage Laboratory and the High Current Laboratory, which is more commonly known as the Lightning Laboratory. So we have these two big research groups and we collaborate within these departments, which is very beneficial for our research and it's very good for our working environment where we can test things out in different laboratories under different conditions. It's very important to us that everything that we're doing has a real-world application.
National Grid as a company is a significant partner for us in our research. And the main reason is because we've been working with them for a long period of time and we developed a lot of useful technologies for them. So in the power sector, we're looking at the insulation of the system, reliability of equipment and reliability of the system, so we ensure continuity of supply. In electrical systems, where we need to reduce size, we use what is called gas insulated systems. And the gas that is used is called SF6. Its global warming potential is 24,000 times that of CO2. We need a new gas. So there is research on alternative gases. This research should lead to a solution that will even allow banning of SF6. As academics, we like to see our work being applied and being useful to others. So insulators are used to hang conductors from towers. These insulators prevent current flowing through them, but when they get polluted, current will flow and cause a failure. Our textured insulator is a solution to reduce that failure mechanism. We have now reached the point where we've produced insulators for 400 kilovolt systems, which is the highest voltage on the national grid. And the insulators now are on trial at a substation in North Wales.
So one of our research areas is looking at how lightning interacts with aircraft structures. Especially with new composite materials, this has become increasingly important. And our particular focus at the moment is on nose cones, which protect very sensitive electronics, but they can't be metal, they can't interact with the radar and the other systems that work in there. So we're looking at developing new lightning rods that sit on the outside that take that lightning away to the body of the aircraft. Our lightning laboratory is one of only a handful of laboratories worldwide, and we're probably the most instrumented and have the most diagnostics of any other such facility. And this makes us, you know, one of the world leading facilities for lightning research here at Cardiff University. And it's very important that we can use the unique facility we have to study this further and to better understand things, to protect people, buildings, environments, aircraft.